And we have a caller.
Alrighty.
And with a religious name there, Esther.
Esther.
Oh, yes. Yeah, I guess you're right.
Good morning.
I do want to ditto what the last caller said about you remaining calm, and it's more impressive you have more leverage when you have people listen to your words and not your dramatics.
Thank you.
So that is impressive and refreshing in a broadcast of this nature. But I was just wondering of each of you, if y'all were born into a religious family and as you became adults changed that mentality, or are you from atheist parents, or what made you choose that sort of mentality or that sort of belief?
Well, we just go down the line. We'll start with Joe.
I was raised in a Roman Catholic home. I spent about 9 years in two Roman Catholic private schools, and I was totally indoctrinated, 100%. I went to church twice a week for 9 years. I used to read out of the Bible during masses before the congregations and before my school. I participated in every sacrament that you can get up until about eighth grade. I was confirmed. I did the communion and all the other things, just everything. And
marriage.
About seventh grade in that school, they started teaching us about physical science. And it was very interesting and wondrous, of course, to children. And we were talking about one of the basic tenets, one of the basic parts of science itself, which is the scientific experimental method. And we were going over what all it requires of someone if they have a theory, and that it needs to be proven if they want to call it a fact. And if they cannot prove it, then logically it cannot be called a fact. It's still just a theory, and science either repeats the experiment or moves on. And I said, well, that's a great way of proving things. I raised my hand, and I said, well, teacher, do we have to do that same kind of thing for God? Do we have to prove that God exists? And she came back and said, no, God is exempt. And from that day on, I was a skeptic and a questioner. And when I went to church went to that school. The last 2 years of my time in that school, I was an atheist in a Roman Catholic school. And it was not easy, I tell you what. And after that, I graduated from that eighth grade and went on to a public high school, and it was a real eye-opener about reality, about society and people and different opinions. I realized there were some people who did not believe in Jesus Christ, and it just it helped me to basically look at the big picture instead of the one-way, narrow Catholic opinion. I was able to look at a lot of different religions and decide. And after a while, it just none of those religions made a darn bit of sense. And the more I thought about it, the more I learned, and the more studying I did of religions, you know, the more I'm an atheist.
Oh, okay.
I was actually baptized in the Methodist Church and went real regular every Sunday until I was like 15, until I was big enough to tell them I did not want to go, and they stopped forcing me at that point. And then
did you pursue or start reading into atheism, or did you meet someone who was an atheist and they gave you more information or education?
No, unfortunately not. There was no groups like this at that point in time. I had no idea that there was even other atheists in the group. I did my own research in the scientific point of view. I've always enjoyed the sciences and mathematics and basically came to it at my own conclusion.
In your researches and meeting people, have a majority of atheists been scientifically oriented thinking people?
I'd have to say yes.
We love science. We love the pursuit of knowledge, especially when it was previously unknown. Yes. We support science also and all education, realistic education that's out there.
We're not a majority of scientists. But
okay.
we do support the scientific method in separating fact from fiction. To continue where y'all were, and I appreciate the question, Esther. I was raised in a Methodist home, and my experiences as a child with my religion and my home were very positive. I started going to church in a little small rural country church, and it happened to be Methodist, and that's just where everybody went, no matter what their background was. And I had lots of good experiences in my early years in junior high. So there was no reason really to reject it based on anybody's actions or any kind of dishonesty that I came across or anything like that. I just came to a point where I was able to realize that that it was my personal opinion that I didn't think it was true anymore. So then you have to decide, are you going to act on that or not?
Mm-hmm. So like myself, I'm in the middle of trying to change religion, but I mean I believe in a being, you know.
Okay.
and that's just the way I think. But there's nothing that happened at any particular time that caused you to not believe in a higher being. I mean, not one particular thing, instance.
For most atheists, it's a long, arduous journey of exploration of the world and your own thinking. Some atheists take a year or two to go from believer to agnostic to atheist or whatever. Some take 20 years.
I mean, years. You mentioned that occurrence in the eighth grade, was it?
Seventh, yes.
Seventh, you know, to me, I would consider that as a springboard.
Yes.
You know, but the other two gentlemen, nothing like that occurred. I mean, it was just a slow revolution. Evolution.
Evolution.
There
right?
you go. Thank
Much
you.
Better.
Evolution to the atheism
yes.
thinking.
There was, in my life, there was a period that... I mentioned earlier that I was talking with a girlfriend who was going through some trouble in her life, and she was talking about everything that she felt was troubling her so bad. That she was having trouble with her parents, and she didn't believe in God, and
yeah.
like this. And suddenly it kind of became okay to question that. Now, it was many years later that I would actually call myself
right.
an atheist.
Right.
But at that point, I started the process of wondering, is this true? Is this really true?
Mm-hmm. Well, I again want to commend you on your show and on your the way you're handling yourself, and I also am impressed by the fact that you don't seem to have to belittle religious thinking people to get your idea or your opinion across, and I think that's in this day and age of talk shows where people feel they can stand up and criticize each and everything that they perceive. You're just saying how you feel without the need to belittle or criticize those of us that still do believe in a God, and maybe your behavior or your you being a very gentleman about it will carry more weight in the long
you.
Run.
Thank
y'all
you.
Have a good time.
Come on down and visit us.
Okay. Yeah. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
We have some other callers online.